good trendsetters. Now you look at DeSoto, is you got to get through a winning season. Like, it's a must. You know, it's the norm now.
We had to play some folks, and we played NBA players.
No one believed in them, and they did something that, you know, had never been done.
We had a solid foundation. The only problem is we were in a hellified district. We didn't back down from anyone, didn't run away from anyone. We're going to play good folks.
Yeah, I'm super confident walking in. It's not even close. Yeah. I know we're going to win. You know what I mean? The year before that, we done ran through everybody. You know what I mean? Coming up, growing up, we done ran through everybody.
This team, of all the teams in the history of Texas and the UIL, this team deserved and earned the state championship more than any other team.
And sports, a special send-off this morning for the DeSoto High School boys basketball team. Whichever team wins plays Saturday for the state title.
Well, you look
better. I see they put your name on the outside.
I'm just glad, like I said, they didn't put
memorial
in front of me, you know.
My name's Chris too, so yeah.
Well, like I always said, what goes up can't come down.
So, how does it feel being back in
this
gym? 20 years later.
It was good.
Yeah, really.
Bring back a lot of memories.
Energy
still feels about the same too, yeah.
The greatest game ever played. Right here.
You want everybody?
Yeah, just all the guys. Everybody.
It's a good call.
Don't miss the start.
Yeah. Don't
wait for anyone. Kind of
wild.
Hey,
you take
my
pictures here. Everybody raise up. I'm right back.
You're going to make an Oscar, man.
You got some sandwich trays, fruit trays.
These skitters off me.
Boy.
All the fun, man.
How you doing, man?
Yeah,
Chris
man.
Christian, man.
Eric Bell.
Yeah, man. You looking all grown on me now.
I'm hot, Coach. I'm hot.
Hey. I mean, the coach got mad at me playing Sam Houston. Remember Dante coaching you? Dante came to us. He said, pass the ball, man. Probably shot about five times in a row.
The Helen Morrell and Ty Thomas?
Yeah.
It was like they didn't have some talent.
Everyone,
cause all this shit go through one time,
coach.
Hey, remember this? Out in Odessa,
coach. Why are you taking me out? I can play with two fouls.
Dez, you got those two fouls during warm-up.
I wouldn't call them fouls.
Yeah, and then right after that, James came to the damn bench. You pulled him. Coach, why is he taking me out? I'm hot. I mean, you just made a free throw, James. I'm hot. Why is he taking me out?
Nobody didn't ever want to leave the game.
I thought he was supposed to.
Ball, coach.
How many rings you put on today?
How many rings you got, coach?
How many rings you put on today?
It's 5 out of 6.
No, 5.
You got 5?
One it.
One at Kimball, one at Sy.
Three at,
yeah.
You got that fake silver
bracelet? It keeps evil forces away when you're still here.
Oh my God.
Big Stone! Big Stone!
What's up, baby?
What's going on?
What's
going on?
What's up, bro? What's up,
I'm going to see y'all, man.
Y'all want to?
I'm ready. You see what I got on?
You got your shoes?
Hey, a week from Monday, 11.
I really don't have any, you know, infinity towards that gym as far as a player downstairs. This is our gym, right?
Yeah.
Here. This was our gym. This one and over at Beltline in that dungeon.
Yeah.
That was our gym.
That year was, I learned a lot that year. Coach Martinez, Coach Dyer, you know, put up with me and taught me a lot. And I mean, I was blessed to be here 17 years. I mean, that was the best thing ever happened to me. Yeah.
They cheated us. I told John, you better tell them they died in overtime.
One time he done so hard.
Charles
was like,
I was like, who guys are crazy?
Bro, I chase him down and block one and it's done. Right down there.
Let me step my game up so I can contribute, so I can bring something to the table. Like, I really want to be a part of this. And I think when I told myself that and I just committed, like, I just started going harder with everything. In the gym, staying after shooting, working on my game, trying to get better so I could play and match up with these guys.
James, you mentioned you got free McDonald's.
Yeah, we was rock stars. We, you know, a lot came with, you know, winning.
Now you right. He didn't take no days off. They took days off.
Now, Big Stoke say I took days. I don't remember that. Me taking days off in the weight room. I was one of the strongest guards by far.
Well, that wasn't saying much because he never lifted a weight.
As a team, as players, we still had one goal. We got first, me and Dez always talked about this during our senior year. Like, man, got it. Once we make the playoffs, we gotta win that first game. Gotta win that first game because it really don't count. It don't matter if you go to the playoffs, but lose the game. So, getting over that first hump, getting into the second round, third round, passing the regionals against Coppell and Cedar Hill. I'm not gonna say that. I knew we won, but I know we went through a lot. And so it was like, man, we gotta finish the job now. We at third base. All we gotta do is just take home.
I mean, you walk in, it's like, whoa. Mm-hmm. I remember, you know, DeSoto had no idea, and we're getting ready to go down to Austin, and the assistant superintendent said, man, coach, this has to be a great feeling. You're probably gonna play in front of like maybe 3,000 people. I looked at him, I said, we're not playing at Gregory Gym. I said, this is the drum, baby. There's going to be, you know, 10 to 12,000 people there. Really? They just had no idea.
It just shows, like, the discipline. Like, yeah. We didn't cut corners.
The discipline.
You know,
the
coach,
structure.
Like, we stand on business. Like, everybody, yeah. How they say they stand on business. Coach had strict rules, but it was rules to help us in life.
Right, it was for
you
a
know?
Reason.
You can't miss practice. Like, yeah, you got family stuff. Yeah, we all got family stuff. Right. They all had family stuff. So, right. that just showed me, yeah, I was hurt, you know what I'm saying, not starting. But later on in life, I saw that, you know, I saw that, and I was like, man, that right there helped me to be a better man.
That's something that really, really hit me too, because it wasn't just all about basketball. They were serious about basketball and how we worked out and how committed we was, but they was also serious about making us successful men in life and just good men in general. And so it was just, if you ain't have a good role model at home or a father figure at home, then, you know, coach.
Against soccer, I had hit a buzzer beater. You know what I mean? I'm taking in all this energy. Hadn't been here, you know, this is our time to shine. I remember looking out at the crowd and seeing all them people. I'm like, yeah, you know, this is our time.
It's not just my team and the coaches. I mean, Coach Martinez had been there and some of the guys had seen it, but nobody in DeSoto had ever been down to the state tournament. You know, they had no idea what it was like. You know, it was just like, oh man, Lord, get me through this week.
Monkey got off our back. The monkey was off our back. DeSoto never went to a playoff game. We never was going to win. And just to win the state championship in the fashion that we did, it was like a monkey got off our back. It seemed like DeSoto as a program.
Community.
It turned the corner.
It was great to win, but it was just great to win together.
Yeah.
I mean, we're all still together.
I remember right after I got the job, right after Father's Day, I got the job, and you guys don't even know that. I don't even know if you know. I hadn't even met you yet. And I decided I was going to have open gym. It was a Thursday night. And I was doing camp up in North Dallas. You guys hadn't even started yet. And I came in here, I was excited. I told Marcus Tubbs to tell all the players that we had open gym. Mm-hmm. And I remember I swept the whole floor and no one ever showed up.
Dang.
I said, man, I got some work to do here.
Special kids starting with this group. I mean, this group put this on the map.
The legacy of Chris Dyer and DeSoto ISD is, I don't know if there's words that can explain it.
Congratulations to Coach Chris Dyer.